हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक अगेन ऑन शिक्षा मंडल्स जीएस कॉलेज ऑफ कॉमर्स वर्धा एंड आई एम योर सब्जेक्ट टीचर फॉर द सब्जेक्ट बिजनेस इकोनॉमिक्स फॉर बीसीसीए थर्ड सेल. इन द लास्ट लेक्चर्स वी हैव गॉन थ्रू विद द मीनिंग ऑफ सप्लाई, हाउ द सप्लाई इज डन इन द मार्केट कंसिडरिंग द रेट्स और प्राइसेस ऑफ द कमोडिटी. सो इन द लॉ ऑफ डिमांड वी हैव सीन दैट द फैक्टर्स रिस्पॉन्सिबल. The law of supply exactly works opposite of the law of demand, we can say that. So in law of supply, what we have seen, there were the four factor determinants. We have seen the definition, we have seen the meaning also, along with that the factor determinants. And both of the laws, in law of supply and in even law of demand, the factor determinants are very important to understand the law of supply or to any that law of demand. So yesterday we have seen what were the factors responsible or the elements of law of supply. It was quantity of the commodity, second the price of the commodity, time duration of the particular commodity, and willingness of the seller to sell the product or to sell the commodity in the market. So those were the four factor determinants for law of supply. Again, we have taken the example that how the seller is selling the product in the market. Obviously, when the seller is selling, when there is a consumer who is buying the product, he thinks from his point of view that when the rates of the commodity are lower, I will buy at that time only. And what the supplier or seller thinks, when the rates, I will get higher profit, and when he will earn higher profit, when the rates of the products are maximum. So it works exactly opposite. So in that we have taken the example of 2000 kgs of wheat which a farmer is supposed to sell in the market. In that case, what he thinks, that if he is selling the total quantity of the product, then how much profit he is going to earn, then it is his decision, considering the price, considering the time duration in the market, considering the demand of the product in the market, he will make his schedule for selling the product. So total supply is the main source for the supply in the market. From seller point of view, he is considering his total quantity, and when the rates are high, he will sell at that time only, then he will earn maximum profit. It works exactly opposite of law of demand. So in that we have seen the four factors just now we have discussed. So again, what is the supply? We will have a brief look. Supply is a relative term. It is a relative term, and it correlates with what? Supply is a relative term. It is related with, or it is always considered in relation to the price and time. So why it is said time and price? Time means the quantity, the total stock he is having, and out of that stock, considering the rates, situation in the market, he has to earn maximum profit. So to earn maximum profit, he will not sell the total quantity of his product in the market, but he will make the bifurcation. In first stock, he will say, supply them, say for example 500 kgs. If the rates are good, then he will sell in the market 1000 kgs. He will decide. So the time is important here, and the prices. So it is a correlation between time and the prices, or price of the time. Understand? I hope this is clear. So supply is summarized, or supply summarized as under. So what are the factors which are responsible? We have written here. Okay, SX equal to F. It is a, again we have seen, it is a relationship. It is a relation between price and time. So PX, PZ, T, O, C, EX, G, P, T, S. So what is the, the explanation of this particular point? So SX is the supply of the particular commodity X. So X denotes the commodity X, and S for supply. PZ, price of the related goods. Now, why it is said related goods? When a producer, when a seller selling his product in the market, so what are the factors involved, or what are the factors included in producing that particular commodity is considered in PZ, that is price of the related goods. When he is selling the product, he must have considered the rate of the raw material, rate of the machinery used, again this the labor, which the amount for on labor he has spent. So these are the related goods. So he is deciding the prices of his product considering the factors involved in producing the commodity X, and that is why price is decided considering the related goods. So next is technology used. So in producing that commodity, in that specific commodity, which kind of technology is used, accordingly the rates or prices are fixed. Then O, that is other factors. What are these other factors? These other factors are out of economic concept. Here there are some geographical conditions, okay, there are such situation in the market that supply is going to affect. So O is the other factor. In that case, in law of demand also we have seen the other factors, geographical condition, weather conditions, these are the other factors which is considered under point O. So what is C? Cost of production. This is the main component, we can say. Cost of production. How much cost that producer has spent on that particular commodity, production of the commodity. That is cost of production. And then EX, that is expected price of the commodity X. Every time this X denotes the commodity X. So EX is expected price of the commodity, because see, it is a relationship between the price and the time. So the supplier, the seller, is not going to sell the total quantity of his stock. So expected price, he is waiting for the prices to get up and down in the market. If the prices are high, he will sell his more product in the market to earn maximum profit. So expected price of the commodity X. GP stands for government policies. GP stands for government policy. T is taxation policy, of course, which is decided by the government. And then S is subsidy. Subsidy is the last point responsible. But these are the main parts or the main elements which are considered in case of supply. So supply is summarized as under. So these are the total factors which is considered while deciding the prices of a particular commodity to sell in the market by the seller. So I hope these points are clear for you. Now we will move on to law of supply. That is the statement of law. Again, the statement of law or the law of demand, which has been introduced by the economist Alfred Marshall, saying the law of supply is also given by Alfred Marshall. Here, now what he says? Other things being constant. See, this is the law, this is the definition. So you cannot change a single word while writing in the exam. You have to write as it is. So other things being constant, the higher the price of a commodity, greater the quantity supplied, and lower the price of the commodity, smaller the quantity supplied. Every time you have to consider the, in case of law of supply, in case of law of demand, consumer behavior. It is a study of what? It is a study of consumer behavior. But in case of law of supply, you have to think the supplier point of view. When the seller will sell in the market according to or considering the situation in the market. When the rates of the product are high, then he will sell the maximum of his stock. But when the rates are low, he will keep the stock of that commodity with him, and then only he will sell when the prices are high in the market. It is exactly opposite of law of demand. Okay, so if you are clear with law of demand, then you can easily understand the law of supply. So to understand the law of supply, you need to be at the end of supplier, at the end of the seller. And by understanding the law of demand, keep yourself at the place of consumer, being a buyer, so that it is easy for you to understand the meaning of it. So what this says, other things being constant means other things do not change, they remain constant. The higher the price of the commodity, greater the quantity supplied. So what the supplier will do, what the supplier will sell in the market at that time only, when the price of the commodity greater the quantity supplied, lower the price of the commodity, smaller quantity supplied. Clear hai? Means what? When the prices are lower, the seller will be not interested in selling. Correct? Are you getting my point? Okay. When the prices are lower, seller will not be interested in selling his product in the market. But when the prices are high, and why the prices are high? Because to earn the maximum profit. And if the seller, the producer, supplier wants to earn maximum profit, then what he will see? What kind of market situation he will consider when the rates are high? And in what is the same thing we have seen in the law of demand? It is exactly opposite. So the prices, the time, quantity of the commodity, willingness of the supplier, willingness to sell, and time duration. These are the 3-4 very important factors. And if you remember these elements, these 4 factors, then it is easy for you to understand the meaning of it, the concept of law of supply, at the same time the statement of law of supply, and the factors responsible, or the the elements of the law of supply are the very core. It is a hard core of the law of supply. These 4 factors you remember, then it is easy for you to understand the law of supply. So supply is a relative term. Again, I will just repeat the whatever the explanation we have gone through today. Supply is a relative term. It is always considered in relation to the price and time. Okay, these 2 things, this is the relation between price and time you need to understand. So supply is summarized as under. These are the factors: technology, then price of the related goods, expected price, then government policies, taxation policies, subsidies. These all are the factors which are considered while assuming the law of supply. And then we have seen the law of supply, or we can say it is a law of statement of law. So you need to see, you cannot change the single word in this law, statement of law. You should write in the exam as what the definition says. Each and every word should be same. You cannot change a single word. So other things being constant, the higher the price of the commodity, greater the quantity supplied, and lower the price of the commodity, smaller the quantity supplied. So this is enough for today, and I hope the concept is again clear. In the next session, we are going to see the schedule, the law of supply curve, and then we will see the assumptions and exceptions of law of supply. Thank you.